Greece finally finds its spine, joins hands with Egypt and Italy to go all out against Turkey. Turkey has been bullying around in the Eastern Mediterranean and Greece has become the biggest victim of Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan's belligerence. Ankara has been issuing frequent NAVTEX, navigational telex, with the aim of carrying out research, exploration and drilling activities in Greece's continental shelf. Till now, Greece seemed kind of subdued in its attempts to counter Turkish attempts of encircling the entire Aegean Sea. But to be fair, Athens felt compelled not to confront Turkish in a brash manner because it understood that the European Union, EU, will not back Greece in a direct physical manner. But Greece is now confronting Turkey through alliances with countries like Italy and Egypt. Greece is an influential naval power with an expansive continental shelf extending out of various islands in the country. Geography plays to its advantage, creating a long exclusive economic zone EEZ. On the other hand, Turkey is not a signatory to the UN Convention on the Law of the Sea Unclos and has its own interpretation of the international maritime law. Ankara and the Libyan Muslim Brotherhood simply claim that islands do not have continental shelves or exclusive economic zones EEZs. Turkey-Libyan Muslim Brotherhood interpretation of the international maritime law. A deal signed between Turkey and the Libyan Muslim Brotherhood leader Fayez al-Sarraj in November last year aimed to steal the Greek maritime space by robbing its islands of its EEZs. Turkey has been strongly backing the UN-backed GNA in Tripoli, while other countries like Italy, France and Egypt have put their weight behind the Haftar-led forces. Now, it is clear that Turkey has been expanding influence in Libya in order to dominate the Eastern Mediterranean. Greek position that islands have EEZs is however supported by Unclos and therefore Athens is basing its international transactions in the Eastern Mediterranean on the recognized maritime law. This is a plan to surround Turkey from all sides. In June, Italy and Greece signed a deal dividing the exclusive economic zones EEZ of the two countries in the Ionian Sea. For Athens, the EEZ deal with Italy hinders Turkish president's ambitions to dominate Eastern Mediterranean. It directly impinges upon Turkey's ambitions to carry out research activities in Greece's EEZ. Therefore, Turkey's state-run media also suffered a massive meltdown after the Italy-Greece EEZ deal. In fact, Greece and Egypt have also used the Unclos to counter Turkey's maritime expansionism. Greece and Egypt have decided to delimit their own exclusive economic zones EEZ. The Greek foreign minister, Nikos Dendias, hurried to Cairo to meet his Egyptian counterpart, Sameh Shoukry. The Egyptian foreign minister said part of the signing ceremony of an agreement for the establishment of an exclusive economic zone between the Arab Republic of Egypt and the Republic of Greece. The agreement is fully in line with the median line principle when the exclusive economic zone of two countries extending up to 200 nautical miles from the baseline overlaps with each other. The EEZ deal with Egypt will help Greece in cornering Libya in its south. Greece strongly believes that the latest deals will help it in securing its maritime interests in the resource-rich region, according to the diplomatic sources quoted by Hellas Journal. Dendias has directly targeted the Turkey-Libyan Muslim Brotherhood deal with the latest move in Egypt. He said, the agreement between Turkey and al-Sarraj is now the trash bin. Greece has cornered Turkey from all sides. Even the island of Cyprus is closely aligned with Athens because of its acrimonious past with Ankara and the present-day maritime conflicts. Within the Eastern Mediterranean, Turkey is the only country that has conflicts with all its maritime neighbors, whereas Israel, Greece, Cyprus and Egypt have created strong multilateral ties only in order to contain Turkish influence. Greece has used the respect of international law and Unclos to good effect. Turkey may not understand or want to understand the international law of sea. But the general framework of Unclos is binding even on non-signatories like Turkey, and Greece is using Unclos-based alliances to keep Ankara in check. Thank you, please support my channel.